Hello, it's Chef Lee here, and today we'll be making bread dough. This is the same recipe that we use to make our flatbreads or pizzas and a lot of other recipes throughout our cooking. This is the straight dough method that we'll be doing today. So you can see that I have here in front of me, I have a little bit of warm water. This water is really just warm to the touch, okay? If you put your finger in it and it's neither hot nor cold, that is the temperature of water you want. Now to that, I'm going to add just about half a teaspoon of natural sugar. This is the sugar in the raw. We're just going to dissolve that into the water. And what this does is allows the yeast, it gives the yeast a little bit of food to eat and activate and to be able to do their thing. So then we add in the yeast. You can just sprinkle it in, let it kind of bloom on top of the water. Okay. And once the yeast is mixed in there, and we're going to start adding bread flour. This is bread flour that has a good gluten content because you do need the gluten when you're making bread in order to make all the rising action and the good flavors and so forth that good breads are known for. This is an organic wheat flour that is unbleached. So we like everything organic and as least refined as possible, of course. There, I want to add just a little bit of salt. Just a pinch of kosher salt here. And what the salt does is it allows the yeast to, it kind of retards the yeast growth just a tiny bit, which actually gives some really good flavors into the bread product. Table here. Just put a little flour around on the board. We're going to knead this by hand. It only takes a few moments of kneading here. You're probably going to use about another cup of flour in all, so about 4 cups for the total recipe. And you see when you're kneading, what you're doing is you see how it's going to fold it over onto itself, push down, fold it over on itself again, push down. And it really is just that same action through the entire kneading process. You just turn it, keep going, keep putting a little more flour underneath because you don't want it to stick to the countertop here. Still a tiny bit sticky, so I'm gonna give it just a little bit more flour and knead it just another 20 or 30 seconds or so. And we're right about there. It's really a feeling, you know. I always tell people to cook with feeling. So it's a feeling that you get when a dough is kneaded just enough. And that's about good right there. You can see that it bounces back. You see that? How it bounces back when it's pinched a little. That means that the gluten has had time to do its job. And now what you need to do is give it bench proof. So in order to do that, put a little bit of flour on your countertop, set her down there, and put a little more flour on top, and take the same bowl that you made the dough in the first place and just put it upside down right on top of it and leave it alone for a good 30 to 45 minutes. Then you can come back and make whatever bread product you want, from flatbreads to pizza to white bread loaf or rolls, hamburger rolls, hot dog rolls, whatever you like. Hey, now our bread dough has bench proofed long enough. And how you know, you want to uncover it, and you see that it has doubled in volume, and that when you poke it with your finger, the indention remains in the bread dough. So you know that that's good. A really good method here for storing your dough. What you do is you just take a Ziploc baggie, and you want to label it and date it here, and then just drizzle a tiny bit of olive oil into your baggie. Just not even a half a teaspoon, really. And then just smear it all around the inside of the bag. Make sure to get down in the corners real good. And then you just simply put your dough, shake off any excess flour, and just put your dough right in there. And you store this in the refrigerator. But then we'll come back to our dough that we have in the fridge and pinch off a little bit and make fresh flatbreads throughout the remainder of the week. You know, it's really good when it gets a little more fermented flavor. As the yeast continue to develop, just not as fast, the refrigerator actually just slows their growth way, way down. But then they start developing an awesome, like, sourdough kind of flavor over the next few days that we just love. Have a great day and happy cooking!